as court resumed today for the mention of the case in which four people are charged with the murder of city businessman Henry Katanga, the director of public prosecution, represented by Chief State Attorney Jonathan Mwaganya, presented committal papers to the presiding chief magistrate. According to Mwaganya, inquiries into the matter were complete.
Obviously, a painful process. Subject to the law must undergo it, because that is the only road.
The accused persons, who include Katanga's daughters Patricia Kankwanza and Martha Nkwanzi, and two others, will read the pieces of evidence that the state intends to adduce against them. Among them are forensic reports, video documentary of the scene of crime, call data report, post-mortem report, the killer weapon, among others. In the indictment, the two sisters are accused of destroying all moving valuable evidence related to their father's murder. They are charged under the same indictment as their mother, Molly Katanga, who is already facing charges for her husband's murder.
Now, we have very many inmates in Luzira who are sick, but they are answering to court. We even have now mothers giving birth in Luzira, but answering to court. These are not any special, Your Worship.
This court will therefore go ahead and issue warrant of arrest in respect of accused number one.
Prosecution alleges that on November 2nd, 2023, at the family's residence in Chwatu Road in Nakawa Division, Kampala, Nkwanzi and Kakwanza, with knowledge that certain items could be required as evidence in a judicial proceeding, intentionally removed, destroyed, or concealed them to prevent their use in the case. Molly Katanga, the widow, reportedly remains hospitalized due to injuries allegedly sustained during the incident involving her husband's murder. Still in court, the minister in charge of Karamoja Affairs, Mary Goretti Kitutu Kimono, has formally filed an application in the Anti-Corruption Division of the High Court, seeking to block her prosecution in the new charges of causing government a 1.5 billion shillings loss. This time, Kitutu wants a permanent injunction restraining the Inspector General of Government, Betty Kamya, from prosecuting her over mismanagement of funds for peace-building activities in Karamoja. Kitutu contends that the same subject matter she is being prosecuted over is already being prosecuted for by the DPP in the Anti-Corruption Court. However, the application could not be heard this morning because the Attorney General has applied before presiding judge Jane Okuo Kajuga to be given one more week to file a reply to Minister Kitutu's application so that they can ably clarify on the matter that is being prosecuted by the Inspectorate of Government and the one being prosecuted by the DPP as provided for by the law. Story compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.